Yeah, I want to talk about adding coarse sand to your garden beds. The discussion is, how good is coarse sand, or how good is fine sand, or how does it work? So when you add sand to any garden, you really change the consistency of that material. And what I mean by that is the sand has this ability to create voids. Voids in clay, voids in loamy soil. It has this really nice attribute that it adds this aeration to any type of soil. The soil scientists are really adamant about not adding sand to clay soils because they turn into cement, according to them. To avoid that, always add the third element, the organic element, to your soil. So just don't add sand and to your clay. Add sand, humus, organic matter, leaves, pine needles, whatever it may be, to that clay as well, so you have that organic component in there. I want to talk about what we've been doing lately is we've gone as high as 50% coarse sand to our existing garden soil. So 50 to 50. And it's a very high ratio, but we're getting away with it quite effectively. Things are doing really well in those well-drained materials. It rains a lot here, so we have that advantage. I will explain something that is, again, a little bit on the odd side. We've noticed that we have older garden beds where we added, let's say, 40% sand, coarse sand, to the garden, and we ended up planting it immediately with alfalfa or whatever it may be. And we realized that when we come back after 4, 5, 6 months, that we can't see the sand anymore. The sand is kind of encapsulated with soil. It's broken down quite a bit, and it looks like topsoil. So it's just basically through the roots, through the sun, through the rain, through the motion of something growing in that material, it has completely turned into topsoil. It has a very different look, a very different appeal when it's 6 months into the future. So remember that we have the problem, we have very little soil here, we have to carry it in from the road, so we prefer to figure out a way here to do it on site. So when we add this river material to our gardens, this stuff does so well. It is so loaded with nutrients as well. Fantastic. The reason for this video is I want to make sure that people aren't so scared of adding coarse sand. I prefer coarse sand over really fine sand to the garden. If you have any problem situations with your soils, try to add some coarse sand to any garden bed, especially if you have lots of clay. So do a good mix, and your soil will pay back with incredible growth. So remember that maybe soil needs to be conditioned in different ways. Experiment with it. I'm a big fan of pine needles. I'm a big fan of using that coarse sand that is a little bit coarser than really fine sand. The fine sand I find goes really hard, and the coarse sand keeps everything nice and fluffy. So the next time you're conditioning your soil, put a couple of pails of coarse sand in there, and you'll see the incredible benefits of it.